Austin an opportunity to cool off a bit. Now let's talk about your match tonight, if you don't mind. You against Hunter Hearst Helmsley and that 200-pound bodyguard, China.
Yo, Hunter Hearst Helmsley, 1997 King of the Ring. Hell, I've been there and done that. Hunter Hearst always eating his little caviar. I'm fixing to open up a can of whoop-ass and see how he likes the taste of that. As far as China getting in my way, I ain't above punching anybody's lights out, and that's the bottom line, so that's what you can expect from Steve Austin.
Thank you for joining us.
Shut up.
We'll be back. Stone Cold Steve Austin, ladies and gentlemen, preparing for his matchup with Hunter Hearst Helmsley, and that will be next on the War Zone. Earlier tonight, ladies and gentlemen, on Raw, is the British Bulldog, along with Bret Hart and Owen Hart, were paying respect to their country. The national anthem was playing. Little did they know that they were about to be attacked by an individual, Stone Cold Steve Austin. With a steel chair, Austin showing not only disrespect for his rivals, but indeed disrespect as well for the country that they come from. Austin completely carried away. There was an immediate apology from the World Wrestling Federation as a result of his actions. How will this crowd respond to Austin tonight? War? Well, that can bring us to one individual. And here he comes!
The following contest is scheduled for one ball. Making his way to the ring from Victoria, Texas, weighing in at 252 pounds, one half of the World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Champions, Stone Cold Steve Austin.
And this man, ladies and gentlemen, to quote Stone Cold Steve Austin, he doesn't give a rat's ass. Whoa. And no, he doesn't. And some people love him for it. Go figure. Austin really looking forward to get back in his home state of Texas next Monday night. Whether or not Austin will be politically correct tonight. He never has been. If China gets in his way, I don't think Austin will hesitate to plaster. And I'm not proud to say
you
that.
You think Steve Austin would punch out China?
Given sufficient provocation, he just might. If anyone would here in the WWF, it would be Stone Cold.
If he throws that punch, he might just have a heck of a fight on his hands.
He might. He's got one on his hands right now, I'll tell you that. Hunter Hearst Helmsley. Helmsley set up for the ride. Helmsley putting on the brakes, and look at Helmsley get right into Austin's face. Helmsley is a competitor, but a smart one. He won't take unnecessary risk.
No doubt about it, Helmsley will keep his faculties together. He's a thinking man's wrestler. Stone Cold Steve Austin, however, is so reactionary.
Yeah, exactly.
Austin is an impulsive, instinctive competitor. The hothead.
He's a hothead, and he goes by his guts. Oh, wait a minute. Oh, look at this.
I thought Austin was going to indicate that Helmsley was number one.
And we got the message. We got the message. We know what you mean, Stone Cold. Locking up now with Hunter Hearst Helmsley. Mankind. Oh, my goodness. Thumb to the eye by Hunter Hearst Helmsley.
Yeah, Stone Cold just got the finger.
And Mankind wanting to be Stone Cold Steve Austin's tag team partner next week. Oh, no!
Oh, God!
Unbelievable!
Helmsley almost wiped out the cameraman from that velocity of Stone Cold Steve Austin. These Canadian fans are loving this opportunity.
Here they come.
To see these two Americans tear each other apart.
And wait a minute. What's he doing? Scooped up.
Oh, no. Oh.
Stone Cold Steve Austin rolling back into the ring.
Take a look at this, McMahon.
All right. There's another one. To the buckle and...
Whoa!
And right now, Helmsley getting in the ring, all right. But maybe coming in the hard way.
He went out the hard way.
Yes, he did. Stone Cold Steve Austin next week live on Raw from his home state of Texas. From San Antonio, it'll be Stone Cold and whomever his partner will be against the Bulldog and Owen. And that was so close.
Oh, what a close one.
You notice, oh, there's a cover.
And Austin, not quite able to put him down.
You know, Austin's not proud of many things, but he's proud of his Texas heritage, I would assume. Austin's got that state of Texas tattooed on his left calf.
This one's going to be a Donnybrook. No doubt about that, ladies and gentlemen. We shall return. We'll apologize for taking a break and be right back with more action.